My name is Haukur Hilmarsson. I'm an Icelandic national. I am speaking from Raqqa on the 1st of December. I traveled to Raqqa and Syria and Rojava with a Greek organization called Ruis or Esta, the International the Revolutionary Union of Internationalist Solidarity. Since I was a teenager, I have been attracted to revolution, and for a long time, I considered the meaning of the point of no return. In traditional politics, liberal politics, there is always a point from where you can return. You never make a full commitment to any kind of a cause, not even for a limited period. You never do anything that might change your life forever. I come from an anarchist tradition, but I regard the anarchist paradigm as being finished. It will not be able to achieve its major ends by its end, the means that have been promoted through the 1920s actually. It has, however, the possibility to affect other revolutions. And as I am myself too deeply ingrained in my anarchist ways of thinking and working, I see no other options to implement the anarchist ideas than to enter the ground where it has some kind of leverage and can merge with other revolutionary forces successfully. This ground at the moment is here in Syria and in Rojava. The democratic confederalism, although I do not fully endorse one aspect of it, is the only political system existing in the Middle East anywhere approaching real democracy, real freedom. Within it, political organizations can work in a non-sectarian manner. There are all sorts of freedoms which are expanded to the maximum capacity given the regional security, religious freedoms, ethnic equality, women's liberation, socialism, and so on and on. All of this has been achieved through a struggle, armed struggle, in which several comrades have lost their lives. Not several hundreds, thousands, losing their lives all the time. And we in the West have been relieved to hear about every victory that they have had against the fascists of Daesh. And at the same time, we have refused to join them, or not even thought about it, not even considered what it would take to ensure the ongoing victory over fascism, which is in the interest of us and in the interest of all humanity. It is totally unfair to have that position and to not consider the possibility of contributing to this process. It is also a great loss for any kind of radical politics not to achieve a first-hand experience, not to draw the lessons, not to bring them back to our own liberal situations where revolution seems ever less possible and where the capitalist modernity rules supreme in every aspect, especially in ideological aspects. These are the main reasons that I came. And I hope that for my loved ones, they will suffice to provide some kind of an explanation, help them to come to terms with the space that will be left when I